Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. One of the powerful images that is indeed witnessed from the Arbaeen commemoration in Iraq is the multi-million walk towards the city of Karbala in honor of the sacrifice of the Ahl al-Bayt, peace and blessings be upon them, and to visit the shrines of Imam al-Hussain alayhi salam, Abu al-Fadl al-Abbas salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi, and all the shuhada of the day of Ashura. But one thing that perhaps people may ask is, why the walk? Could these pilgrims, could these individuals not go via other means of transportation? Why can't they take cars? Why can't they take, for example, a train, or perhaps just be taken towards the shrine by any other means? Why walk for days and days? It's hot, there are security problems, perhaps it's congested. People of different age groups come, the elderly, children, people who are even disabled, or some even who are blind, and so on. And indeed, this is an important question. Why walk to Karbala? Of course, there are many narrations, authentic, established, about the merits and the excellence of taking steps and walking towards the shrine of Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. In fact, there are chapters dedicated to this in books such as Kamilu Ziyarat, which highlight the great benefits of every step towards the ziyarah of Imam al-Hussein. But one thing I would like to ponder and reflect upon is the Quranic basis for walking. See, in the Holy Quran, in chapter 22, verse number 27, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَذِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَىٰ كُلِّ ظَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍ عَمِيقٍ. And proclaim the Hajj to people. They shall come to you on foot and on lean camels, coming from all kinds of distant places. This verse, although clearly demonstrating the importance and the obligation of the pilgrimage of Hajj, has also another key learning point. Quran talks about walking on foot before other means of transportation. And you find some of these Sunni scholars such as Fakhruddin al-Razi and al-Qurtubi have come forward and said this verse highlights the benefit and the superiority and the much reward of those who walk towards the pilgrimage and the sacred house of Allah rather than those who take other means of transportation. And that's why the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam is being recorded that they indeed used to walk, Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam 25 times, Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam a similar number, and so other members of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam. So that's number one. But number two, why more effort? Why more struggle? In the teachings of the religion of Islam, we are told that the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam, when he was presented with two options or two ways to do something, he would choose that which is more difficult. In fact, this is a narration which is found in Al-Kafi Sharif, volume 8, page 130, that Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam says, when the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was presented with two options, both resulting in the pleasure of Allah, he chose that which was more difficult. And exactly the same we find as far as description of Imam Ali alayhi salam given by Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. One of our great scholars, Allama al-Hilli, ala Allahu ta'ala maqama, he says that the reward of attaining or doing certain tasks is directly proportional to the degree of hardships. And he says that without the necessary difficulty, that reward diminishes greatly. The higher or the more difficulty, the greater the reward. Now we begin to understand how walking for ziyarah is so significant. In a narration of Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam in Wasa'il al-Shia, volume 11, page 78, it is said that he said, this is a sahih hadith, that Allah is not worshipped through a greater or better way than by walking. So notice the brilliance of walking to Imam al-Hussein alayhi salam. It's not only because the Ahlul Bayt have mentioned, and that by itself is sufficient. And not only the fact that the Ahlul Bayt themselves did this, but because when we take a harder option, to refine ourselves, it's a matter of self-struggle. It is more rewarding because we are following the Sunnah of the Prophet and the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Now, of course, that is why so many of our scholars followed this and walked towards the shrine of Imam al-Hussein alayhi as-salam. For example, Mirza Hussein al-Nuri, when it has been documented by Agha Buzurg al-Tahrani, he says that during the time of Sheikh al-Ansari, the walk by foot towards the Master of Martyrs was well established. Afterwards, because of poverty, he says, less people paid attention to it. But when Sheikh al-Ansari noticed this, he paid attention to the issue and became adherent to the walk. During the visitation of Eid al-Adha, he would carry his belongings and walk alongside his companions. And then the last year, he says, I was honored to serve the Sheikh who was walking. After the ziyara, he also returned to Najaf by foot. And so you recognize that this was a practice of the ulama, and many others followed in the same way. When we walk, we honor the sacrifice of the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, but especially remember the caravan of the captives who were dragged, who were beaten, who were abused, who were humiliated. And of course, when we walk, we have the water and we have the comfort and the food, but we remember their suffering. And we pledge allegiance to the principles that they stood for, and indeed establish a great sign of Allah, a sha'ira, which keeps alive the beautiful religion of Islam.